All right, guys. Now, in this part, part two, we're going now to build the REST API with Laravel. So in this part, we'll create the backend for a simple e-commerce application. So we'll create the models and then the controllers and then define the routes within our endpoints. So what I want you to do here quickly, I want you to go to the terminal and then I want you to type this command. So PHP artisan make model. And then here you're going to have, so the model is going to be product. And then here you're going to have M. Now M means that you're going to create migrations at the same time. So when you run this command here, you're going to have several items. So you're going to have a table products, which has been created. And we're also going to have a model, which will also be created. So now let's go to the model. So control P, and then I just type the model. So here I'm able to get the model here. So what we need to have in this model, since we are creating a simple e-commerce application, now within our model here is whereby we have, let me just explain something. At the start here, we're going to use the use factory, and then below it, we are going to have this. So we're going to have protected. So this is protected available. So this is going to be like this. So you're going to have something like that, then equal to this. Now here, what you're going to do is you're going to define the name. You're also going to define a description for a database, and then you're also going to set a price. In other words, these are the entries that you're going to receive within our application. And then here we're going to, they are going to be recorded within the database. So what happens with protected fillable property here that I've defined, it is a model class. It's a model class of an array which contains all the attributes. Of course, here the attributes can be mass assignable. So we are talking about mass assignment, whereby it's a feature within Laravel, whereby you can create or update multiple model attributes within a single segment. Such as, for example, you can create a new model with these given attributes. So you're going to find ourselves when we create a controller, we're going to, for example, to call product create, and then we're going to give the name one, for example, product one, description, we're going to give it a description of the product, and then the price, we're going to give it the total price of that product. So that is what we're going to do there. So in this case, we're just calling the name, description, and price field with a fillable property so that we can now fill them out. Now, with that out of the way, so that is done. So here, we are now going to identify the table that we just created. So this is the table. So the table here, we're going to have this table. So in this table, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add some few items. Let me just copy this and paste it here. So I'm going to change this to string because the name is a string. So you're going to have this a string. And then inside it, we are going to specify the string that we have. Of course, it is the name. So let me just copy the other one, which is this. And then I'm going to copy and paste it there. So this next one is going to be text like this. And then the text here we're going to have is the description. So we have the description like this. And then lastly, we are going to have this, which is of course the decimal. So the decimal, we are going to set, for example, the price. And then within the price, you're going to set. Now this price, you're going to give it 8, comma, and then 2. What does this mean? This means that it's a way of defining a new column. In this case, the price, of course, is the column, is the name of the column, and then the 8 is the total number of digits that the price can hold. And then 2 is the number of the digits after the decimal point. So for example, we are going to have, let's say, something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is it 8? And then 2. Let me see. This should be, so it can hold a maximum of 8 digits. So it can hold up to this maximum. I don't know how many these are. They should be, yeah. So they should be around 8. And then here we're going to have two decimal places. And that's what we're going to have in there, sorry. This should be, yeah, so we're going to have it in that way. And then next, so once that is done, so this is the ID, name, string, price, and then this, we are just going now to run this migration. Once we just save that. Now here, before we run the migration, of course we created our database from the last tutorial, and the database is e-commerce app, which is this one here. So let's just go ahead and run this by running PHP artisan migrate, and we are going to migrate that table. So when we come back here and go to 127, which is a local host, let's just click one of the, so here we can locate the e-commerce app, and we can see products table, and of course it has the whatever we had defined. So this is what we have just defined. Now let's continue. So now the next step here is just to create the product controller, which is of course is going to handle the logic for our API. So what I want you to do is you're following up. So let me just clear this. So I want you to create that controller. So PHP artisan make controller, and then you're going to have product controller like this. And then here I'm going to give it this. So we're going to have these two dashes, which is going to mean the API. So what does this mean? This basically means that we are giving it, we want it to, for it to be created within our, that is, the command will generate a controller, of course, with a required RESTful resource, and which are index, create, store, show, edit, update, and destroy. So that's why we are giving it the API like this. So when I click enter, and then here we can go to Control P, and then I go to product controller, which is now this one. You can see here it has the this RESTful resource, and which are of course the index, store, show, update, and destroy. Now these are the ones that you're going to handle, for example, when you access a certain endpoint, when you want to view a product, when you want to, of course, when you want to insert the product, and then when you want to show the product, as well as update and destroy. All right, so once that is done, now we need to go to we need to go to the routes here, and then within the API we need to define this. So we are going to have route here, it's going to be this. Now within this route we are going to define API, and then you're going to say API resource. So what this means is that because we ran the API, it created for us the resource, the index, the store, and so forth. So you're going to define products, and then we're going to have product like this. Actually, it is this one here, and then here, because it is, you're going to define it as product, then class, like that. So what this means, and of course when we have this, let me put that like that. When you have this, we also need to import this class, because we're going to use it, which is already imported. So this class, which is coming from the app HTTP controllers, and then product controller. All right, so that is what we have so far. Now what this means is that this single line, of course this one, it will generate all the necessary routes for the RESTful resource. And of course, if we want to see for example, let me show you something here. For example, we can go ahead and run the PHP artisan route list like this, and what you're going to see here, we're going to see all the necessary routes that we are going to use, for example, within our, sorry, actually you're not saved. That we're missing something here. Let me just clear this again. So here, run the, yeah, so now it is able to identify. So you can see here, what we have here is we have the API. It is going to API, then slash products. And of course, within our API, what we defined here is API resource, and then this. So since this is generating our CRUD, our CRUD API endpoints, so what we have is, for example, when you want to update a product, of course, we have to identify the product ID, and then we update that product. If you want to destroy any product or delete, of course, you have to identify the ID, as well as when you want to get any product to show, which is going to products.show, then you're also going to do the same thing, products.update. And so these are the routes that we are going to use when you want to access a product in terms of updating, deleting, of course, showing and storing. So I believe you get something so far. Now let me clear this. Just clear that. Now what we are going to do, we are going now to implement the methods in product controller. So this is how you'd go about it. So now once you have established the routes here within our the single line route, and we have this, so let's come back here and let's establish this method so that they can begin working for us. Now what you're going to do here on the first part on the index, we are going to, since we are creating an e-commerce, a simple e-commerce, we want to be able to add a product, of course, and then be able to show. So on the index method, what I want you to write here is just a return response like this. So this return response, what's going to do is that it's going to return whatever we get on our table, which is the products, and then we're going to say return everything like this, and then the 200 is just for HTTP status method, which is going to show us that everything is okay. So that is on the first part of our product. Now once this is done, so here we have this, so we are returning this, so this means I need to import this this part here. So we need to have this because we are using now the models. So that is the product.php model, which is this one here. Now let's go to the store. So on the store part, there's something that we are going to do here. So the store method, of course, it is used to validate the incoming request for the new product. And of course, what you're going to do here, we're going to start with something called, we're going to have the validate data, which is a variable I'm going to define there. Then I'm going to have requests method, which is of course to request validate. And then here we have this. So the first part here is the name. So the name, and then here we're going to say the name is going to be required. Use that pipe sign. So here we have, so the max, of course, of typing that name, of course, is going to be 255, which, of course, it makes sense. And then here, the next part here, we're going to have, which is already within our data, our table, is the description. So the description, you're also going to set it to required. And we're also going to set, no, this one is going to be that way. And then the other part is the price. And then the price here, we're going to have it as required. So we are setting this as required. And then this is going to be numeric because we want the person to input a number within this. So of course the, yeah, so that should be it. So I believe this is easier to understand, as you can see. So we need to have that there. Now the next part on this same item, we are going to have the product, we're going to create a new product record within our database. So what I'm going to have here, I'm going to have something like, I'm going to define this variable product, and then I'm going to set it to be equal to the product model. And then I'm going to have a create eight statement, which of course I'm going to say at validate data, which is that one there. So what do I mean here? So what I mean here is that we are creating a new product record in the database with the validated data. And that's what we have on that part there. Now, once that is done, there's something we're also going back to do. But before that, let's continue. So now on the next part here, we're going to return the response. Then this response is going to be in JSON. I believe you understand when I mean JSON. I believe you understand what I mean by JSON. So the product there. And then 201. What does 201-200 mean? So these are different HTTP status code, which of course 201 means it's an HTTP status code for a product has been created, while the 200 here, it is for okay. Once, for example, you request a specific data and then it is returned to you. So the product is created, returned as JSON response here, as you can see. And then the second parameter, of course, the 201 is for HTTP status code for created. Now let's continue. So now let's go to the show method. So on the show method, we are going to have several things. So here we are going to first do this. We're going to define this variable product, which is already there. And then our product model. So here we are going to say find. So of course here we wanted to find the ID of a given product, of a particular product, because the products, of course, they're going to have ID. And then once it finds the ID, then it's able to show it for us. Now I'm going to do something here. So retrieve the product from the database with that ID that we have. And then here we're going to check if the product. So I'm going to use an if statement to check if the product, if the product was found. So here I'm going to return this statement here. I'm going to say return response. And then here I'm going to have this. So I'm going to have the product like that. Now this product, I'm going to append it with the 200. So the 200 means, of course, this one means it is just a status for okay. So here we are checking if the product was found. Then we return the product as a JSON response with the HTTP status code, which is, of course, it's the 200. And of course, we want to check to ensure that the product is found, or else if the product, if the given ID doesn't contain any product. So we must have an if statement, which is going to return this. So you're going to have that return response, and then we have the JSON. So within the JSON here, we're going to have, so here I'm going to have a message. And then within the message, you're going to have, so let's write something if the product was not found. So product not found. And I believe this is very important when you are developing these applications. Is very important because, for example, if the product is not found, it's good to show the product. We return the JSON, we return a 404 not found HTTP status code if the product was not found, which I believe is very important for you to do. All right, so that is on the product, on the show. So let's also go to the update. Remember, all this is the ones that, all this logic, we are going to use it on the view side when we'll be getting to view. Now on the, let's go to the update. So on the update, we want to update a product, and to update, of course, we first have to validate that product. So I'm going to copy this code here. Then I'm going to come here and paste that. So once I paste that, here what I need to do is to, as well, actually I'm also going to check. So I'm going to use an if statement to check. So here we define, we pass the variable, which is product in this case. And then here I want, so here what I want to do is that I want to update the product with the validated data. Because the data, of course, it has, that is the product has been validated. So now we want to update that product. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to have a product, which I'm going to call. And then here, I'm just going to call the update keyword. And then here, I'm going to call the validated variable so that now we can validate our product. All right, so I believe that is good. Now, so the next item is to return the, sorry, this is to return. So I'm going to return a response here. And this response here is going to be, of course, the JSON. And then inside the JSON, we're going to have product and then 200 for K if the product has been updated. Now, else you're going to also have, in case we don't, product doesn't get updated, we're also going to return a 404 of not found. So here we're going to return the response like that, and then you're going to have the JSON. So you're going to have the message, and then here we're going to have this. So basically here, just the product not found. All right, guys, so this is, of course, this is now the 404 of not found, and then we end it like that. Now, where's this red lines coming from? So here we check the product. So the product is undefined, and let's check from where? From above. So what? So if you encounter this product is undefined, it means we need to have passed this here. So let's remove this string because you're not using string here. So here I just need to define the model. And then here I need to pass this within this function here, which is product. So the product now becomes defined here because we have passed here. Okay, so I believe we also should be having the same thing on the store. Okay, so on the store, because here we are able to call the return response JSON, so we don't need that one on the store. Now the last part here is to delete the product. So what I'm going to do here now, we need to delete this product. So what I'm going to do, it's very easy, but before we delete the product, you have to check if the product is there. So we're also going to do the same thing. So I'm going to have if product, we're going to check if the product was found, and then if it is, it was found, then we're just going to call this statement here at product, and then here we just call the delete keyword, which should be able to delete the product just like that. And of course, if so once that is done, we're going to return a JSON response, which is going to be response, sorry. So we're going to have this, and then sorry, this should be within the null. So this is a 204. So the 204 is we're just returning a 204, which means no content of HTTP status code. So that is the whole idea there. Okay, now since we have this, let's come here. Because we have an if, we also need to have an else. In case the product was not found, we are also going to return something similar here. So I'll copy this one and paste it. So return, and then here we're just going to have a message. So here we're going to have this. Just going to have a message which is going to say, this is going to say product not found, like that. Of course, this is a 404. Then here we need to have this. So that's a 404, and then you need to have this as we end. Now we also need to do the same thing. We also need to pass this product here. So we need to have the product. Then here we need to have this so that it is defined here. Right, guys, and that is what we have within our for resourceful. That is resourceful REST API. So that is what we have, and that's what we need to pass within our Laravel. Now, once that is done, now we need to go to the other part, whereby since the CRUD functionality is working. Okay, so let's continue. So now here, what I need us to do is to list all the products and be able to identify each product. Now, I want you to have this software installed for you to test your API. This is called Postman. You can find Postman just by going to their website. I believe you'll be able to find Postman here. So you can just click and then just install, because it is there for you to use. It is free, and as well you can upgrade if you need any upgrade. Okay, now once this is done, we need to run this PHP artisan serve, which is going to serve for us this product. Of course, we can check our Laravel to be working. Okay, now what I need us to do is first to be able to see if all went well. Now, for example, if you want to list all the products, for example, actually I don't have products here, so we'll need to create a new product before we list. So for example, if you want to create a new product, of course you come here, because these are the different HTTP status code. So for example, you can change to post, then here you just append the API, because remember the route goes to API and then slash, for example, products. So for example, here I'm going to have this slash products, and then here I'm going to have name, then the value of the product. So let's say this is shoe, for example. Here we also add description, so description there, and so the description of the product could be Nike shoes, so for example, something like that. And then here we need to have the price, because remember this is what is on our database, because this is what we have here. Remember, this is what we have, so we are just giving this here so that they can be inserted within our table products. So let's say here we have 99.99, something like that. So let's try to send and let's see if everything is working well. So it returned the JSON response, which is 201, which means creator. Remember, we defined this one on this part here on our controller. So this is what we defined here, so that once the product has been created, we need to show the, this is what, this is, sorry, this is a, this is 201, and the 201, of course, it is this one here. So once the product has been created, because the store is the one that is responsible for creating the product, then it shows this message here. Okay, so let me just quickly create some few products and then we continue from there. Now, I've inserted several products, and they are about, as you can see here, we have 7 of them. Now let's do some, for example, you can do something like, if you wanted to show a single product, so how would you go about it? So for example, let me remove these ones. So let's say, for example, you want to show a single product. So to show a single product, you just need to have the route as it is defined within our controller, because when you come back here, you can see we are going to API, and then slash the products, because we ran the, remember when you ran the command PHP artisan route list. So here we're going to have this. So you're going to have, for example, let's say I want to get the product with the ID of 1. Of course, I send this and it gives me the 200. Okay, remember we defined this one within our controller. So the okay is when what's on the index, when we get the product that we want to get, and that's what we get. So the product here with the ID of one is that one, and you can see it has the particular details. Now somebody may be asking, what about the database? So when you come to the database, you can see the product that I added, they are also recorded within the database. Now what else do we so remember there you can get any product. Let's say the product 6, you can also do the same thing and you'll be able to get that product like that. You can also do something else here. You can also update a product, and to update a product you normally go to put or patch, these two of them. So let me choose that one. So here to update the product, what you need to do is, for example, let's say it's product with the ID of one. So what I'll need to do here within the body of the request, which should be, of course, remember this is what we call the JSON response. So when I was writing here return JSON response, this is what we are getting here. So this is the JSON response here, the key value pairs. Now, so we are updating a product. So how do we do, or how do we go about it? So the product with ID of one, so here I can have which product is this? I believe this is not the product. So let's first do what? Okay, so let's just have this. So this product, so the product with ID of one is this one here. Shoe, Nike shoes. So let's say the shoes are coming from, which brand do we go for? So let's say the shoes are coming from Bata. Let's say the shoes are Bata. So here we have shoes, and maybe let's say, I don't know, it was shoe. So the name was shoe. So I'm adding shoes. So that is also, that's already an update. So the description here I will add is, so let's say these are Bata shoes. I can as well update the price to, let's say, like this, something like that. So the Bata shoes, and then the product is with the ID of one. So let's send and let's see. So once I do this, you can see here what we have here is the product with the ID of one has now been changed to shoes, Bata shoes, and then the price is what we have just placed here. And when we go to our table and try to refresh this, we can see that the product has been updated. That is, the product shoes has been updated, as you can see. Now, we also have the issue of, for example, now let's say you don't put, let's say you updated without putting the name. For example, Bata shoes, and see, let's see what will happen. Let's see what will happen. So what will happen is that there will be an error of the name field is required. Why? Because you can see here we are validating our data before we do anything with it, and that's why we said here we have to check if the product is found, and then we update the validated information. So if you try to, of course, to update these two without the first one, then that error will be there. Of course, you can come here and comment them. Let's say, for example, you can do a comment of, let's say, like, let's say this one here, like this. So that means this will still be updated. But in this case, for example, we are just updating everything. So you need to know that needs to be that way. So the next item is to delete a product. And of course, to delete a product here, what we can do here is, let's first get the product like that. So the product is this one. So let's say I want to delete the product to the ID of 6 or ID of 7 so that they can be 6. So here I just call the delete, which is an HTTP status code. And then once I call that product, what is going to happen is that I just need to send. So when I send here, you can see the body has returned with 204, which means no content. And of course, this is what we have defined here down here, so that it finds the product. Once the product has been found, it is deleted, and then this is returned as the response within our Postman, like that. So this is very important, and this is what we are going to use to write in our Vue application. So guys, let's meet in the next video.